In a recent interview with The Intercept, Edward Snowden endorsed ad blocking as a security measure against ad-based malware. In fact, in our recent episode on ad blocking, which you can watch over here, many of you brought up the issue of malvertising as a reason why you block ads. YouTube commenter Neil Labaton mentioned, among other things, that we never even explained intrusive malware-based ads. Well, Neil, I love a challenge, so here we go. Malware is a general term for small pieces of software that aim to do harm to your computer. Malware can typically fall under three types: viruses, worms, and trojans. Once these have been installed on your computer, they can modify or delete files, greatly reduce a computer's performance, and even allow hackers to collect data on you. You can most likely get malware from downloading software that is infected. In fact, one of the first major viruses ever, Brain, was spread by students who downloaded illegal copies of software from a floppy disk. Nearly 1 million pieces of malware were created every day in 2014, making the risk of cybercrime one of the biggest issues threatening our online safety. And even worse, through malvertising, malware can now be downloaded to your system just by you looking at a website. Online publishers sell ads through ad networks and exchanges. Advertisers can bid on these ad spaces to place their ads on the publisher's webpage. Utilizing a security flaw in Adobe Flash, the program that is used to display the ads, cybercriminals can use ad networks to place infected ads on a publisher's site. When viewed by a regular internet user, malware can automatically infect the user's system, even if they don't click anything. The rise of malvertising has led many major publishers to boycott the use of Adobe Flash, opting instead to use HTML5. Adobe themselves have asked users to proceed with caution when using Flash, and even announced that their new animation tool would be HTML5 based. And as mobile devices, tablets, and smart devices become more prominent, so too are cyber attacks on these devices. About 16 million mobile devices were infected with malware in 2014, the biggest target being Android devices due to its open platform. But iPhone users shouldn't be so smug. Earlier this year, hackers infiltrated the App Store when they released Xcode Ghost, a malicious version of the app developing platform Xcode. So, while it's becoming easier for hackers to infect our systems without our knowledge, there are still steps we can take to protect ourselves from malware, such as keeping our antivirus software up to date and... what's that? Wait, don't click that! Don't click that! Hey, thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel for more Mashable Explains every week. Also, leave a comment below and let us know what you think about the show and what you'd like us to explain next. Peace.